You need to pin that up every 1 minute.
Do
they?
Yes. It's going to be Friday or Saturday next Saturday.
That's good.
So we're here in the Chapel Royal at Hampton Court Palace, just on the edge of London, and we're in one of the most important and significant buildings in the palace. So this is a royal chapel created by Cardinal Wolsey and then finished off by Henry VIII in 1536 when he installs this incredible and beautiful blue and gold ceiling that we're looking at over my shoulder. This chapel is really fantastic at picking up little bits of the whole history of Hampton Court Palace. So you've got Cardinal Wolsey initially constructing it, Henry VIII creating this beautiful ceiling. You then have Oliver Cromwell coming along, nearly destroying the whole thing, but luckily it's saved. And then Queen Anne creating this wonderful reredos. And then that continuity of use coming through. This is a space that has seen some of the most important moments in British history as well. So, what's happening today? How's Peter going on?
Peter's doing really well.
Nan, that's all combining to create
it's
this
so
wonderful...
It's so amazing
wonderful
to have this opportunity.
It's amazing, isn't it?
How they're economical, but utilising the highest quality of craftsmanship, the most minimised quantity of wood, but the best quality of oak.
Yeah. And right now, for the first time in 20 years, we have a scaffold up against it so that we can record it, properly understand how it was constructed, and crucially make sure that it's in a good condition now and well into the future.
And you see the equation here is right, a method and a write-up of treatment proposal that need to be agreed. And
I'm trying to find somewhere I can start.
Not squeaking.
So we have got flaking paint and some small level of wood.
Yeah, so we discovered a little but very significant previous restorer's signature, which is dated to 1847. And that's the year we know that the major campaign took place over this space on the wall paintings as well as the ceiling. So it's really nice to connect ourselves that, yes, they were here at this level as we do now.
So this is the time that we came up to this level in over 20 years. And of course, we found a lot of dust.
So we tried already using some deionized water. So this is a purely the water treatment, what we call the aqueous treatment, and see what sort of effect it could give us. And these, you can see in my raking light, the large square patch, which has been already cleaned with water, and then see how much difference that it could make. And we are pleased to see this result. It really brought this vibrant colour forward.
So we think that the world will continue this work to make the whole...
Maybe not surprised, but 20 years of dirt is a lot of dust. You know, there's a huge layer of cleaning work to do. But it's really incredible to see some of the fineness of the carving, some of the real incredible innovation that is being used by the designers and the craftspeople at the time to create this beautiful woodwork. I think it's also quite reassuring for me as a sort of an amateur builder at home to see some of the corners that are being cut. So you have lots of sort of loose ends up there. You have lots of joints that don't quite work. A bit of that is the impact of time. But there's a wonderful sense of sort of even here in a royal palace, you have people doing the best work they can, but sometimes you just need to cut a little bit of a corner, particularly when you get up into the really high points there. So when you're right up at the ceiling, they know that the king's probably not going to spot that, and so they can be a little bit looser with how they're finishing things off.
Like the operation.